Now, I want to give a brief introduction of this topic. As we know, the astrology is the study of everything in universe beyond Earth atmosphere. That including objects we can see with our naked eye, like the sun, the moon, the planets, and all the stars. By studying the cosmos beyond our own planets, we can understand where we came from, where we are going, and understand the conditions which are impossible to recreate on Earth. Broadly speaking, the universe is the in astronomy, in universe plays the role of laboratory. So this is the brief introduction. I think all the participants will get in-depth knowledge regarding this topic from our honorable speaker, sir, Dr. Himadri Sekhar Das. Now, before starting inviting our resource person, I would like to invite our principal, sir, to give an introductory and welcome speech. Now, it is over to our principal, sir, Mr. Partho Dev, sir. Sir, please unmute your audio.
Thank you, Pranav sir. Good afternoon, everyone. Respected speakers, sir, of today's webinar, faculty members, scholars, students, and all the participants from different parts. In the very beginning, I, on behalf of Pranav Jibli College, welcome our research person, Dr. Himadri Sekhar Das, sir, Associate Professor, Department of Physics, Assam University, Silchar, who has published more than 75 research papers in peer-reviewed journals. 10 research scholars have been awarded PhD and 5 scholars have been awarded MPhil under his supervision. Moreover, Dr. Das sir was honored by Honorable President of India, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, in the Inspire Teachers in Residence program at Rashtrapati Bhavan, held from 6th June to 12th June 2015. Other local award also in his credit. Dr. Das sir is a life member of the International Astronomical Union, Astronomical Society of India, and Physics Academy of Northeast. Therefore, to get such a knowledgeable resource person as a speaker in our today's webinar is definitely a proud moment for us. And also, I would like to thank Dr. Himadri Sekhar Das sir for accepting our invitation in his such busy schedule. And I also welcome all the other participants, faculty members, scholars, any students of different institutions in today's national webinar on amazing world of astronomy. Dear all, hereby, I would like to inform you that from the Jubilee College, Bukajan Karbian Ashram, manager run by Bharat Sabha Sangha and philanthropical organization, was established in the year 2010, secondary section only with science and commerce stream, when there was no science and college was there except Dipu Garwan College in Karbi Anglong district. And from 2012, we have started degree classes. Presently, we are providing arts, science, commerce at HS level course, while BSc and BCom at degree level, with prime objective to provide quality education with moral development of the students. Hope in these pandemic situations, as we are unable to come to the students in direct contact, so alternative way we choose to contact the students, fraternity, education fraternity, the scholars. And today's program, basing on that, what we arrange. In this platform, I'd like to thank our physics department faculty members, Mr. Pranav Kumar Singh and Mr. Amalanjati Das, for arranging such a wonderful webinar today. Hope all of us definitely be benefited from today's webinar. Thank you. Thank you all. Over to Pranav sir.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable words. Now, before I inviting Himadri Sekhar Das sir, I just request everyone during the presentation time, please mute your audio and close your video call so that it will not interrupt this presentation program. And at the end of presentation program, we have interactive session. In that session, all the participants are requested to send your comments and questions through message box. And our speakers will try to answer all the questions as much as possible within the time. Now, I would like to invite our honorable speaker, sir, Dr. Himadri Sekhar Das, who is the professor of Assam University Silchar campus. Now it is over to you, sir.
Yeah, so am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So thank you very much for inviting me in this occasion. I know this is a post lunch session. And it's a good time for sleeping, but still this lecture is organized so that my job is to give a brief idea about astronomy. So respected principal, sir, one of my student, I'm very happy that he is faculty of this college, Omlan Yukidash, and other faculty members and my beloved students. First of all, let me tell you that we are also admirer of Guru Maharaj, Sri Sri Panabandhuji Maharaj, under whose his name is actually associated with this college, Panab Jubilee College. So I'm very happy that I could deliver a lecture in this college. So my talk will be of 45 minutes, but before that I will try to finish the talk. I understand, because whenever you talk much, people will lose attention. So that we always remember. And one more point is that in between talk, I will ask you some questions, particular to students. So I'll prefer that you'll be going to answer my questions. And not very tough questions, but the questions are very easy. So you need not to bother about the question. And also, you can continue in the chat box also. Chat box is also open. If you have any query, you can just send your comments or send your questions in the chat box. I'll try to answer. Okay. So basically, the topic is Amazing World of Astronomy. So I have written the word world. It means that the topic is very huge. And within 30 or 45 minutes, it is not possible to complete the session. So anyway, I'll give you a flavor of astronomy. So can you see the screen which I have shared right now? Can you see the screen? It is clearly visible. Okay. So before going to start the session, I'll just want to write down my address because I am from Department of Physics, Assam University. And you can see when I will write the address in as an astronomer, so my address is too big. Actually, I'm representing India. I'm also representing one continent, Asia. I'm also representing one planet, planet Earth. I'm also part of a small planetary system. It is known as solar system. I'm also part of Milky Way galaxy, which is also part of local group. and finally universe. So all of us are actually part of universe. But when an astronomer writes his address, so he'll like write like that. Okay. So before going to the subject, I'll just show you some cartoons because I like cartoon too much. And if I can include this in your my talk, I think it will be little interesting. So this is one of the cartoon I am sharing with you in the screen. You can see I'm so hot. So this is sun, you can see, and sun is having a speck. So we call it sunglass. So he's saying I'm so hot. Of course he's hot. So these are different phases of moon you can see in the screen. It is full moon, then super moon, new moon, and blood moon. I think these names are already known to you. Full moon is the Purnima. Super moon, you know that sometimes moon comes very close to Earth. And during that time, what happens, we call it super moon. So you can see that the cartoon is made with Superman. Okay, new moon means it is the new baby, Omavashya. And the third one is the blood moon. Blood moon, you know that during the lunar eclipse, the color of moon becomes red. That's why it is known as blood moon. And in this cartoon, you can see that there is a interaction between moon and earth. Sorry, sun and earth. And earth is saying, you are so heliocentric. And sun is saying, you are so geocentric. You know what is heliocentric? Heliocentric is when we actually, helios means sun. So heliocentric means it is sun-centric. And geocentric means, geo means, so I think, okay, so I'll make it full screen. Just wait for a minute. Yeah. Now it is okay.
Okay, sir. Now it's okay, sir.
Yeah. So there is a discussion between, and suddenly the situation was not good, and then two of them are saying you are so heliocentric, and again they are saying that you are so geocentric. So there is a separate meaning of that. Probably you have heard about geocentric model and heliocentric model. So geocentric model was actually the earlier idea when we thought that Earth is at the center of the solar system and everything around Earth is moving. Okay, but later you know that astronomer talked about the geocentric heliocentric model. In that model, it was considered that sun is at the center. So in this particular cartoon, it is showing. So now you can see that this is moon and she is sleeping. And this is the dancing with the tune. Solar system, sun is at the center and all the planets are dancing. So this is our family. And we are part of this family. And here in this cartoon, you can see that sun is actually keeping a record of the revolution of Earth. And after that, Earth is asking, how is my time? And sun is saying, it took you 365 days again. Sweet, at least I keep beating Mars. Okay, so this is another message that whenever the planets are away from sun, the time period will increase. Orbital period will increase, and it is coming from the Kepler's law. I think all of you know. The nearest planet is Mercury, and it takes only 59 days to rotate. But whenever it comes to Earth, it takes 365 days. If you go to Mars, it will take around 400 days. So this is another famous cartoon. Probably you have heard about space junk. Space junk means nowadays if you go to space, you will see that these are all are crowded with the different space satellite. Earlier around 50 years ago, one person, John Glenn, was the first person to go to the space at that time from America. So he was saying that when I went there, there was really space. Nowadays, you can see that all are crowded with these satellites. And in this cartoon, you can see that one person is looking at the star. He is zooming the sky. And right to that person, you can see one person is looking at them using microscope. And he is also zooming.
So what is...
So you can see here that both of them are zooming. One is looking at the micro world, and there is looking at macro world. So one astronomer is looking at the sky, and one person came. Maybe the universe is not expanding. Maybe it's just you. You can see that this is a fat person, and this is you know that the universe is expanding. This is the common idea, and is coming from the Big Bang theory that the universe is expanding. And in this particular cartoon, this is nicely portrayed. And now you can see that what are the smileys used by astronomer? Probably you people nowadays use WhatsApp, Facebook, and all this. So astronomer normally use this type of smileys, okay? But you will not get this in WhatsApp, but you have to install it in your system. So if I ask you a question, who first discovered telescope? Can anyone tell me who discovered telescope?
Galileo?
No. The first person who actually discovered telescope was a Dutch eyeglass maker. His name is Hans Lippershey. In 1608, he first actually took a patent of this telescope. But after 2 years later, Galileo used his technique to use first telescope. You can see the telescope in the screen was the first telescope used by Galileo. But remember, Galileo was the first person to use telescope in astronomy. That's why we are confused with the invention of the telescope, but telescope was not invented by Galileo, but it was Hans Lippershey who first invented telescope. Clear? And probably you heard the name of Sir Isaac Newton, but Isaac Newton had invented another type of reflecting telescope, and it is known as reflecting telescope. And in 1668, after around 60 years, he first used this. And nowadays, everywhere in all the observatories of the world, people use reflecting telescope. Actually, telescopes are of two types. One is reflecting telescope, another is reflecting telescope. But normally, astronomers use reflecting telescope. Now, you know which is the hottest planet in the solar system? It is planet Venus. Some people have confusion that since Mercury is very close to Sun, it is the hottest planet. But remember, it is not Mercury, but it is planet Venus. The reason is very simple, because in Venus, greenhouse effect is there. Because in the atmosphere, sulfuric acid is there. And because of that, what happens, heat cannot come out from the Venus. And it is too hot. It is so hot, around 400 degrees Celsius, that even it is so hot enough to melt lead. One of the metal. If you put lead on the surface of Venus, it will immediately melt. So you cannot send any spacecraft inside the this Mercury because Venus, because immediately it will melt because of the high temperature. Largest moon in the solar system. Our moon is not the largest, but the largest moon is the Ganymede. And it is the largest as well as the most massive moon of Jupiter. Jupiter means Brihaspati. And if you ask me what is the second largest moon, it is the Titan. And it is the second largest moon in our solar. Titan is the moon of Saturn. And probably you have heard the name of one watch, is the Titan watch. And this Titan is coming from this Titan moon. If you ask you what is the tallest mountain in the solar system, the answer is the tallest mountain in the solar system is Olympus Mons. It is there in Mars. It is three times the height of Mount Everest. And you know that what is the height of that particular mountain? It is around 21 kilometer, and the height of Mount Everest is around 8.8 kilometer, and it is about the three times the height of Mount Everest, and it covers an area of around the size of Spain. And another information I would like to tell you that it is the largest volcanoes in the solar system. Next is, what is the largest asteroid in solar system? It is the name of Ceres. It is now listed as dwarf planet. So it is the largest asteroid in the solar system. And Vesta is the second largest asteroid in the solar system. These are some of the objects I have talked about. Asteroid is a small size celestial objects which are actually rotates around our planet Sun. And sometimes it comes very close to our Earth, then you can see this type of material. So nearest star to solar system, I think all of you know, it is Proxima Centauri. It is the nearest star to the solar system. Distance is about 4.26 light year. Nearest galaxy to Earth, this is Andromeda galaxy. So why I am telling all these facts, because I think from childhood, probably you people have some idea about astronomy. And these are actually the just to check whether you have that idea or not. Before going to the deep topic, I'll just telling you all this. And you know what is galaxy? Galaxy is a collection of stars, black holes, all these planets, then comet. These are contained in a galaxy. So this is our nearest galaxy. You can see in the picture, the name is Andromeda galaxy. Now, obviously, the question arises, what is astronomy? Astronomy is the branch of science which deals with the celestial objects, space, and the physical universe as a whole. Okay? And remember, astronomy is the mother of all sciences. So the age of astronomy is very, it is ancient. We don't know exactly at what time astronomy subject has started, but it is a very popular subject. And as I was saying in the morning that if you want to understand astronomy, don't need any background in science. The person from arts background, science background, or commerce background can actually understand what is astronomy. So astronomy is the branch of science which deals with the celestial objects, space, and the physical universe as a whole. And the person who study this subject, they are known as astronomer. Obviously, the next is people always confuse with astronomy with astrology. What is astrology actually? Astrology is a pseudoscience. Pseudoscience means it appears to be a science, but it is not a science. Okay? So this is known as pseudoscience, which claims to divine information about human affairs and terrestrial events by studying the movements and relative position of celestial objects. Means the Jyotish, they come to you and they tell you your future based on the position of planets, and they also tell you that your daily life is inspired by the position of those planets. Okay? And again, I'm telling you, astrology is not a science. And those who study astrology, they are known as astrologer. We are not astrologer. We are astronomer. So at the beginning, I am telling you that astronomy is a science. Astrology is not. Astrology is known as pseudoscience. Okay? So basically, astronomy and astrology are basically different thing. Okay? So if I ask you, what is the difference between astronomy and astrology? It is about 50 IQ points. What does it mean? It means that if you have IQ, then you'll understand astronomy is a science. Otherwise, you'll not understand what is astrology. And another belief in astrology is that astrology is inversely proportional to one's knowledge of astronomy. So if you know astronomy very well, you'll not believe in astrology. And if you don't know astrology, then if you know astrology more, it means that you don't know astronomy. So this is a mathematical concept I'm just telling you. And now I can show you one space telescope. And that space telescope is known as Hubble Space Telescope. And remember, trust me one thing, astrologer did not help design this. Astronomer have actually designed these instruments. Now I will tell you some misconceptions in astronomy, okay? What are the misconception in astronomy? Just I'm telling you. Earlier people have idea, I told you in the beginning, that people had idea that the Earth is at the center of the solar system. The planets, sun, moon, and everything rotates around Earth. And that was known as geocentric model. What is geo? Geo means Earth-centric model. So people had belief on this type of model, okay? And this is the correct explanation of this. You can see that sun is at the center. He is the father. And the sun is our Earth, and Earth is rotating around sun. We had a misconception that Copernicus first suggested Earth revolves around sun. I think in many books this is written, that Copernicus first suggested Earth evolved around sun. This is wrong. Actually, it was the Greek astronomer Heraclides, who for the first time in 388 BC to 315 BC, he was there that time. And later, Aristarchus of Samos first came with the idea of heliocentric model. But that time people had don't want to believe this idea. But later, Polish astronomer, means Poland, the astronomer from Poland, Copernicus actually elaborately studied those models, and he actually he had taken the idea of the Aristarchus Samos, and he later had given this idea. But remember, Copernicus was not the first person to give the idea about the geocentric model. You'll be very surprised to know that people in earlier days had believed that Earth is flat. Nowadays, all of you know that Earth is round, but earlier people had idea about the concept that Earth is flat, okay? And this is the Hindu mythology. And in Hindu mythology, you can see that the Earth is sitting on something. Something means four elephants are there. And these four elephants are standing on a tortoise, big tortoise. And this tortoise is, I don't know where it is staying, but this is the concept. And there was also a concept that if these elephants moves a little bit, then the earthquake occurs. So this was the Hindu mythology earlier times. But remember, not only in Hindu mythology, if you go to other mythology, this concept is coming. This is another picture of this giant tortoise is taking the earth. Now, if you take the idea of this conception, if you go to Hebrew means Yehudi, or if you go to Israel, they have the same idea. They have also this type of idea, and you can see here this is the earth, and this is the great deep, and this is the heaven to earth. Okay, this is heaven. So through this you can go up. So here also the concept was concept of flat earth model is there. Even in Islam also, you can see Zakaria Kazvin's model in this particular map. You can see they have also idea about the this flat earth model, and they had also thought that the earth is flat. So you can say that almost in every religion this concept of flat earth model was there. And you will be very surprised to know that still one group of people on this globe still believes that earth is flat. And if you Google it, you can see that people are a small group of people are there who still believes today that earth is flat. If you don't believe me, just Google it, you can see it. Why people had this idea? Because that time people thought that if earth would not be flat, then what will happen? We will go away from the earth. Okay, because the normal idea is that if you take anything on the spherical object, it will flow on the down. You can see that even water flows out down. And here also you can see that the earth is, if you tilt it up, then also water goes down. Because earth is covered with water. And there was a false concept that if you consider earth to be a spherical one, then where the water will go? Water will also go down to the space. So that's why the flat earth model was actually rejected by the people of ancient times. But later, whenever Sir Isaac Newton came up with the gravitation, laws of gravitation, then you might have noticed that all the bodies in the solar on our earth is actually attracting towards the center of gravity. And that's why everything around us is going towards the center, isn't it? That's why you can stand erect, or water, everything is actually controlled because of that. So this was the idea, earlier idea, people had that misconception that earth is flat. But nowadays you know that earth is not flat. We had another wrong idea that all stars look same. Same means white color. But remember, I'm telling you, all stars does not look, all stars do not look same. The colors are different. Some are red, blue, green, yellow. Different types of colors are there. If you look at a star from far away from the city and in a village, in a clear night sky, you will see that the stars are coming with different colors. Okay? So this is another misconception. And another misconception during that time was that the Earth is the largest object in the solar system. It is larger than the Sun. So today you will laugh at this concept. But earlier, people had this idea that Earth has giant, Earth is the largest object in our solar system, but it is larger than the Sun. Another wrong concept is this: meteors are falling stars. You might have heard about this, that tutte hue tara. Okay, so if you make a wish, your wish will be granted. So this is what actually we believe. But remember, this shooting stars are not shooting, these are not star, but remember, these are actually the meteorites or ulka. I think it is the Bengali or Assamese name is ulka. And this actually, whenever this meteorites enters into the Earth's atmosphere, because of the friction with the Earth's atmosphere, it burns out. And it appears to us that the star is falling. But remember, it has nothing to do with the stars. Another misconception is that during, I think, two, three, four years ago, I got several messages in WhatsApp that the only man-made object which is visible from the space is the Great Wall of China. And that is also wrong. If you look at, this was a photograph taken, you can see one of the photograph here. And you can, if you look at this photograph, you cannot spot where the Great Wall of China is. But it is only taken around 12 kilometers from the space. But I'm just showing you, this is the line. This is the Great Wall of China. So remember, this is another wrong concept that the Great Wall of China is visible from the space, or some people believe that it is visible from the moon, a man-made object. That is also wrong. Now we are coming back to the main subject. What are the main components of the universe? And the main component of the universe are galaxy, solar system, star, planets. I think all of you know this. And what about our universe? Universe is made up of the matter and energy in space. And the age of our solar universe is 13.7 billion years old. Okay, so this is the latest age of our solar system, and it composed of billions of galaxies. Okay, so Sun is our name of our galaxy is the Milky Way galaxy. So like Milky Way, several billions galaxies are there in our universe. So you can understand that universe is very big in size. And what is a galaxy? If you ask you this question, a galaxy is a group of hundreds of billions of stars held together by gravity. And what are the characteristics of our Milky Way galaxy? Our characteristics is our Milky Way galaxy, the spiral galaxy. You know what is spiral? It just looks like this, a spiral. And in the outer part of the outer arm of the this spiral arm, our Sun is located. Now I'm just showing you some amazing facts about our universe. If you look at the night sky, you can see only. It is estimated that the number of stars in the universe is greater than the number of grains of sand in all the beaches in the world. So if you collect, so. It is estimated that the number of stars in the universe is greater than. So if you collect all the sands from all the beaches of in the world, so remember, on the clear night you can see only the equivalent of a handful of sand. Okay, only one handful. If you take one handful of sands, these are only visible at the naked star. How much star you can see at night is about 3,000 years. But remember, in our galaxy, we have 100 billion stars in our galaxy alone. So you can see, you can imagine how many stars are there in our own galaxy. If you could travel with the speed of light, you know that speed of light is maximum, it's 300,000 kilometers per second. Okay? And it would take 100,000 years to cross our galaxy. So it is not possible for any human to cross our galaxy, and billions of galaxies are there. So how we can go to that billion galaxies? So it is not possible to visit all those galaxies in our lifetime. So really, universe is a big one. And Jupiter is heavier than all the other planets put together. So Jupiter is the heaviest planet, you know. And if you could Saturn in a enormous bathtub. I think in a bathroom you might have heard that there is a bathtub. And if you put your Saturn planet on the bathtub, it would float. It means that the planet is less dense than water. So this is also an amazing news about the planet Saturn. And you might have heard about neutron star. If you have not heard, no problem. But just I'm telling you, if you take a teaspoon of a neutron star, then it will weigh around 112 million tons. Just imagine how heavy the object is. Anyway, so one more interesting information I'd like to tell you, that if you look at the planet, if you go to planet Venus, the Sun rises in the west. In all the planets, Sun rises in the east, but if you go to the Venus, why it occurs? Because Venus rotates opposite to the direction of Earth. Earth rotates from west to east, but if you go to planet Venus, it will rotate from east to west. That's why it appears to you as that the Sun is rising in the west. So I'm not going to this particular amazing facts. Maybe in some other day, I'll discuss. Before going to the detailed discussion, I'll take another 10 to 15 minutes to complete my talk. So I'll go to this topic. What is astronomical unit? Before going to study astronomy, you must understand what is astronomical unit. Astronomical unit is the distance between Sun and Earth, and it is around 150 million kilometers. It means that it is 15 crore kilometer, the distance between Sun and Earth is. And these are the, you can see 0.387, 1 AU is the Earth. It means it is 15 crore kilometer, and these are the distance, average distance from Sun. And Neptune is the farthest planet. It is 30 astronomical unit. Okay. Now, what is the light year? Light year is the unit of distance, and this is also used by astronomers to know the distance, because distance is very high. That's why people always prefer to use light year as the unit of distance, and it is the distance traveled by light. And you can see the distance is around 9.5 into 10 to the 12 kilometer per year. And just if you look at this diagram, you can see the light. If you look at moon, it will take 1.3 seconds to come light from moon to earth. And for sun, it takes around 8.3 minutes to reach to sun. The nearest star is Alpha Centauri. It takes around 4.4 years to reach light to our earth. And if you look at the Hercules globular, it will take 25,000 light years. And if you look at Andromeda galaxy, it will take 2.5 million light years. So you can just imagine how huge the distance is. And these are the definitions, these are the connection of different units which are used in astronomy. It is astronomical unit, light year, parsec. Now just look at this picture. This is all very interesting. So this is exact scale. Based on that, this was actually prepared. You can see here that this is Jupiter. And the big one is the Jupiter. This is Saturn. This is Uranus, Neptune. And if you look at the our planet Earth, it's very small as compared to this big star, Sun. So you know, it is 14 lakh times. Sun is 14 lakh times bigger than our own planet's Earth. Now just look at this picture. These are the all eight planets in our solar system, and you can see compared to our, this is our Earth here, our moon is there, so you can see it is very small one. And these are the our companion. This is Mercury, this is Venus, Earth and Mars. This is moon. So you can see that the size of Venus and Earth are almost same. That's why it is known as twin sister. Both of them are twins. So this is another diagram. You can see that our Earth is a very small. Pluto, you cannot identify Pluto in this particular diagram. It is so small in shape. Now, if you compare with our Sun with other stars, you will find that our Sun is also a very smaller one. So here you can see Sun is comparing with Sirius. Sirius is one of the brightest star in our solar system. But if you compare Sirius with Arcturus and Aldebaran, you can see Sirius is very small. And you can just put your Sun too small. And if you compare Aldebaran with Antares and Betelgeuse, you can see that Aldebaran is very small as compared to Betelgeuse. And if you compare Betelgeuse with VY Canis Major, you can see that the size is very small. So what is the conclusion? Conclusion is that our Sun is not a very big one. It is a very small star as compared to other stars in our universe. Now, if you look at the night sky, what do you see actually? You will see the collection of some stars, and we just connect this star by some lines. I will tell you why we connect this star by line. Because if we look at the night sky, and if you don't understand astronomy, all stars appear to you as same. Like if you look at look at the cows, or if you look at the same species of dogs or cats, all of them appear to you as the same. So if you look at the night sky, you'll see that all stars look same. But the point is that all of them are not same. But you can identify them, but if you can mark it, imagine a line, you can actually have an idea what is there in the night sky. So there are thousands of stars and many look alike. So how can one bring order to this confusion? So the useful way is to divide the sky into group of stars. A nice way to group them is such that they form interesting patterns. And what these patterns are called? Constellation. I think you have heard about the name. Some questions are coming in my screen. So of course I will try to answer the questions once my talk is over. I can see some students had asked questions. So please wait to finish my talk. Probably I will talk for another 8 minutes or 10 minutes, then I'll come to your questions. I know many questions are arising in your mind. So let me finish this talk, then I'll be able to answer your questions. So if you consider the group of stars, then it is known as constellations. Now it is not look confusing. So how to map the night sky? Because stars are almost fixed in position relative to one another, and it is very good idea if you can map the star. How? If you look at this image, this photograph of our own country map, you can see that these are divided with some states, and each cities or towns are, if it is marked with some dot, then these are stars. And if you look at this particular map, you can actually, if I place my cursor in any position, if you understand geography or if you have studied geography, then immediately you can tell me it belongs to which particular location and which state. Suppose if I put my cursor here in Assam, you can immediately tell me that it is Guwahati, because it's our capital. How? Because I know this, but looking at this map and boundaries, it is possible for me to locate the position. Similarly, the sky is also grouped into different boundaries, and looking at this, we can have idea. Now, night sky, every night you can see that new stars are rising, and some stars are there for a few months. And if you look at night sky, the sky changes. Why it changes? Because of rotation of our Earth. You know that rotation is 24 hours, and another rotation is around Sun. We call it orbital period. It is 365 days. Okay. So this night, day night concept is there, and because of that, the star changes its position. But remember, I'm again telling you, star does not change its position. It is the Earth, because of Earth changing its position, it appears to you as the stars are changing its position. So actually, I'm not going to detail part because the time is already, it is 5 p.m. Just telling you that our Sun actually, throughout the 12 months, Sun crosses 12 different constellations. It starts from Aries, Taurus, Capricorn. I think you have heard this name from astrology, not from astronomy, astrology, because it carries your Rashi, isn't it? It carries your Rashi. Like if I tell you that my Rashi is Cancer, it means that I was born in the month of April. So similarly, actually this Rashis are, or constellations are, 12 constellations are there, and Sun stays in that constellation for 1 month. That's why this Rashi concept is coming. So you can see this is the zodiac symbol, defined zodiac symbol is there, and it starts from Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, like that. So these are different pattern in the night sky. Looking at that pattern, we can have identified these particular constellations. So if you look at the night sky, the only thing which are at rest is known as pole star or Dhruva Tara or Polaris. But all the stars in the solar system is moving with respect to you. Okay. So for an astronomer, it is immediately, if you look at the north sky, you'll find that one star is at rest and this star is Dhruva Tara. And all the stars around you is moving. All the star rises in the east like Sun and sets in the west, and it continues for the months. Okay, so I'm just going to constellations. Constellations names are particularly given in Latin name or Sanskrit people use, and there are around 88 constellations. I'm showing you one constellation. It is known as Orion the Hunter. Orion the Hunter is nowadays it is visible. Particularly, it is visible in the month of winter. So it is also, the Indian name is Moha Vyad Mrigorashi or Kalpurush. So it is very easy to actually detect. So just look at this. First, you look at the right image. You can see that this appears, three stars are very close to each other. and some bright stars are also there in these locations. And the ancient astronomer had thought this as the shape of this tree will create a belt, and this is the hunter, and this is the this is another position, and here you can see this is the hand of this particular hunter. So in ancient astronomer had thought this as a hunter, so it is very particularly very easy to detect this particular star. That's why this shape is coming, and it is known as Orion constellations. Similarly, you might have heard about Lion or Leo constellations. So if you look at this particular star pattern, you can see these are the imaginary lines. So particularly this will not appear in the sky, but these are, we have imagined, and you can see that these are actually matching with a Leo or Lion. And then you might have heard about Sagittarius and Scorpius. What is Sagittarius? Sagittarius is the Dhanu Rashi, and Scorpius is a Vrishchik Rashi. Just look at these two pictures. This is Sagittarius, all the stars, and it would look like this Sagittarius. You know, half man and half horse shape, we call it Sagittarius. And this is Scorpio. Scorpio is very nicely visible. If you look at the night sky, you can see the this particular constellation. But for a beginners, if you don't know how to see the night sky, just I'm suggesting you to download one app which is available in Google Play Store in your smartphone. The name is Google Sky. If you download it, it will act as a planetarium software, and if you place your mobile in the particular direction, immediately it will tell you what is the name of the star or what are the constellation you can see through the mobile phone. So Google Sky is very popular among astronomers as well as the common people. And with this particular app, you can detect which star is visible to your local area. Even it can detect planets, stars, all type of comets, all type of objects which are visible in your area. So I'm not going to detail thing, but you might have heard about the Ursa Major. Ursa Major is also known as the Saptarshi Mandal. Saptarshi Mandal is seen in the northern hemisphere. If you look at the northern sky, you can see this Saptarshi Mandal, and this is how Saptarshi Mandal looks. It is a great bear, and along this tail, this pole star is there, or Polaris. So I'll stop here because already it is only 3 minutes left to 5 p.m. And as I told you, I'll not cross 45 minutes. Before that, I will try to finish. So this is all about my today's talk. And now the question is open for all of you. And over to the moderator. And then we will ask.
Thank you very much, sir. It is very informative session.
Take some questions. So over to,
it is very informative session and very basic understanding of astronomy. Lots of information we have gathered from this presentation. Now, some questions are asked, sir. Can you read this message?
I can read because I can see lots of questions are there. I can see some questions are floating in the comment section, chat box. So I will read some questions. First question is asked by Ankit Lembu. Sir, what is black hole? So though you have asked a very simple question, but the answer is very elaborative. Because black hole is the end state of a star. When a star dies, simply I can tell you that when a star dies, it becomes a neutron star or black hole or white dwarf. So it depends on the mass of the star. If a star is very heavy or bigger star, ultimately it becomes a neutron star or black hole. So in case of black hole, what happens? The gravity is so high that even light cannot come out from the black hole. That's why the name is black hole. So everything around black hole, actually black hole takes all this matter inside it. So this is black hole. And more detailed discussion you can read later, or you can ask me later. because as I have to answer many questions, so I'm not going to next going to Arnob Nath. He has written me, sir. I read an article where it was written that a star is close whose age is 14 billion years. Please explain. So Arnob, let me tell you that the age of the Earth, age of our solar, our universe is 13.7 billion years. It is actually present day. But as I told you, that astronomy, every day astronomy is changing. Means we are measuring the detailed structure of the universe, and whatever is measuring, we are measuring today. Tomorrow, we are close to very accurate results. But we had not discovered any star with 14 billion years, because it is not possible. 13.7 billion years means you are looking at the oldest picture of the sky. Normally, the star which you look at the sky is around some billion years old, 1 year, 2 year, or some million years old. But all the stars are not of the same age. Okay, so 14 billion years, as you are saying, it is not correct, because the age of star is depends on its mass as well as the formation. What is the thought of alien, whether it exists or not? The answer is, if it exists or not, that we don't know, because till today we don't have any idea or any evidences that aliens exist. We have seen aliens in some popular movie like Koi Mil Gaya, E.T. or PK, this type of movies. These are movie characters, but remember, still we are trying to find out the evidences of existence of aliens. Next question is, sir, what is the reason of seeing supermoon? A supermoon is because, as I told you, that moon revolves around Earth in an elliptical orbit. And so our Earth is not exactly at the center. It is just little away from the center. So what happens? Sometimes moon comes very close to Earth, sometimes moon goes further away. We will call the closest approach is known as perihelion, and the farthest approach is known as the aphelion. So whenever sun comes very close to Earth, moon comes very close to Earth, then the size of moon is little bigger, 10%, 5 to 10% bigger. That's why it is known as supermoon. But remember, supermoon does not mean that the size will be very big one. Even with the naked eye, it is very difficult to detect. But with the accurate instruments, it is possible to say whether it is there. So next question is, Abhishek Devnath have asked whether dark matter exists. Yes. So you'll be very surprised to know that of our universe, around 95%, more than 95% matter is dark matter and dark energy. So Pranjit Kakoti is asking me, sir, I heard a fact that the planet Jupiter has almost favorable conditions for living like our planet Earth. Is it true? If true, if life possible in Sobha, it is wrong. Because Jupiter has no solid surface. Jupiter has a gaseous planet. So that question does not arise. But there is a satellite of Jupiter, we call it Europa. And we have found water on Europa. So we are expecting that maybe some form of life may be present, but you don't expect any human in planets Europa. Maybe bacterial life may be possible to exist in that particular moon. You suggest a name of good book where we will get a basic concept of astronomy. Yeah, so Deepak, you will get some good books. If you search over Google books, you will get it. But if you really need it, then I can share you some books with you. Probably today, I'll share you some good books on astronomy.
All right, Dada. Thank you.
Yeah, so, sir, what is the difference between... So, last question, which is appearing in my screen, is by Ananna Kormokar. What is the difference between matter and antimatter? So, actually, matter is created from electron, proton, and neutron. Okay, so these are the basic concept. And antimatter also, whenever you look at matter, antimatter, when you look at the electron, proton, neutron, similarly, anti-electron, we call it positron, anti-proton like this antimatter also, you know, antiparticle also exists. So that's why whenever this electron, proton, neutron will create matter, then opposite particles, mean positron, antineutron, this may also cause and may create a matter, and we call it antimatter. So there may be a possibility of antimatter, but antimatter is created in the laboratory, but in nature, we cannot get antimatter. Okay. No, not everything is. The last question, Abhishek Devna, sir, do dark matter is present everywhere? So still today, we do not know much about dark matter because it was not detected. It is coming out from only from the mathematical idea. But still today, we had not detected the antimatter. But whether it is there everywhere or not, that we also don't know. And everything is not made up of dark matter, because whatever you see, it is the visible matter. Though percentage is very less, but this is made up of the visible matter. But whenever you talk about the dark matter means that everything is dark. So we don't have any idea about the dark matter, but mathematically it exists, that I can say. So Abhishek Ganguly, does gravitation affect the speed of light? So you are asking a very fundamental question. When we talk about the gravitation, this concept of Einstein's space-time concept is coming, because whenever light goes very close to the massive body, it bends, because space-time is bent. So even when light is coming very close to sun, because of the mass of sun, the space around sun is actually curved. Because of that, when light passes through it, it will follow the curved path. So definitely, gravity will affect the light, but not the speed of light. The direction of light, it can affect, but you know that the speed of light is same everywhere. In the vacuum, the speed of light is 3 lakh km/s, and it is a constant. So it will, the gravity will not affect the speed of light, but it will affect the rectilinear propagation of light. Light may be curved because of the gravity. So Pranjit Kakuti is writing, our sun is a green star. What does the fact mean? Actually, this concept is coming from the spectral classification of stars. And from spectral classification, it is classified according to the composition. And because of that composition, it is called known as the G-type star. The G-type star doesn't mean that it looks green color, but G-type star means that our sun is, the color of our sun is yellow, and the temperature is around 6000 degree Kelvin. Okay, so based on the temperature, stars are actually classified. Okay, so with this, I finish the discussion because no more question is there in the screen. I thank all of you for your patience. And as I told, it is a post-lunch session, and I can see many of you are present and attending this seminar. If you have any query, you can send me email. You can visit our Assam University webpage. You will get my email ID. You can contact me. My phone number is also there. You can also contact. And I also suggest you to come to our university, because we have astrophysics specialization in master degree, MSc. So if you study want to study astronomy or astrophysics in your higher studies, you're most welcome to Assam University, because Assam University is the only university in Northeast India who is offering it as a special paper. So over to the organizer. Thanking you.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to request my colleague from Physics Department, Mr. Amlanjyoti Das, for giving vote of thanks. Now it is Amlanjyoti, sir, over to you.
Thank you, Amlan. Yes, sure. Are we happy? Yeah, so after once pandemic situation is over, I will definitely visit your college and we will have a direct interaction with the students. So thank you very much for inviting me.
Thank you, Amlanjyoti sir, for your speech. Now, it is in message box, we will send the feedback link. After fill up the feedback link, you will able to download your certificate within 15 days. So thank you once again to all the participants and our honorable speaker sir. Okay. So we are concluding this webinar. So thank you very much again.
Thank you.
Thank you.